What's up, guys? Your boy, Chef from Off the Dome, and I've been listening to 42 Doug lately, and I realized that Lil Baby has a diamond in the rough here. As you know, Lil Baby has had a fantastic year, and a fantastic 2 or 3 years since his blow up in 2017 with My Dog. Freestyle on YouTube has 340 million plus views and been certified 3 times platinum. He has Yes Indeed, which is certified, I believe, 4 or 5 times platinum. Drip Too Hard, certified 8 times platinum. Lil Baby has huge singles. And although he only has literally 5 top 10 singles, every top 10 single has at least been platinum or double platinum. His album, his debut album going gold, Drip Harder going platinum. His current album probably going to go double platinum this year. Since right now it stands, Lil Baby's album is the best selling album with equivalent sales to units factor into it. He sold 1.6 million copies. So Lil Baby is obviously the top dog in the rap game right now. Next to DaBaby, Roddy Ricch, you have up-and-comers like Lil T.J. and Polo G doing decent numbers for their albums. You still have standard bearers like Drake and J. Cole. And then you have rappers in between. Well, I mean, Post Malone isn't really in the rap scene. Most have to take him out of that category. And yeah, so that's basically the rap scene right now. You have NBA Youngboy, who does decent numbers still, but his album sales always do well overall, and it takes him a little time to get there. But no album has truly sold as fast as Lil Baby's My Turn. And the Babies are Blame It On Baby. Roddy Ricch, that corona's real. And Roddy Ricch is, of course, Please Excuse Me For Being Antisocial, which spent 4 weeks at number one in the Billboard Hot 100. 200. 42 Doug, after listening to him, it seems like, of course, he's from Detroit. He has that trap drill sound, but he sounds like an LA Southern rapper. Atlanta Southern rapper, because he sounds very similar to Kodak Black. And although Kodak Black's releasing apparently songs and whatnot, I don't know if he's on house arrest or in prison. I don't know. I just seen his YouTube channel upload some songs. I haven't listened to Kodak Black in a while. But I know that Kodak Black, from him going in and out of jail, if he would not have been in jail, he would be pretty much where Roddy Ricch is now. That's a fact. He would probably be one of the biggest rappers in the industry. But due to Kodak Black's bad choices, his word choices about different people in the industry, the attacking of Young Miami, and more things that happened over the years, the Nipsey Hussle scandal, he's kind of fucked himself over. But 42 Doug, this is where his opportunity comes. He sounds like Kodak. He has the exact same flow. He has that Southern look, even though he's from Detroit. He signed to literally one of the biggest rappers in the game currently, selling the most. I mean, he's beating Drake. Drake's Dark Demo Tapes, whatever that is. Yeah, they're doing well, but they're not even doing Lil Baby's numbers. Lil Baby's outselling Justin Bieber at the moment. When we talk about equivalent streams and sales, he's outdoing BTS, he's outdoing Eminem, he's outdoing Halsey, he's outdoing Post Malone. Lil Baby is literally beating all these megastars. So, 42 Doug most likely will become the next Kodak Black and take his position. The question is, will 42 Doug make wiser decisions and stay at the position he can, or will he also falter like Kodak Black? Let me know what you think in the comment section. It's your boy, Chef from Off the Dome. I'm signing out. Peace.